your feet like a little wider than your hips. And then just make sure you're not bending down forward. Just sit back in your heels. Yep, and then press three times. Awesome, guys. So welcome. So we're going to go warm up here. We've got four body weight moves. And then we'll pick up some weights and do, I think I have four circuits. Three with weights and then one with abs at the end. So we'll get full body here in about 45, 50 minutes. All right, give me 8 more seconds. 7, 6, and you get 5 more. 4, 3, 2 more, 1 more, and then I just love those side stepping lunges, so we'll just take it right here. And then what you can do is if you want to up the intensity on those, you add like a little pop in the middle. So you can turn and do it like sideways on your mat if you need more room. And again, if you want to up the intensity, you just kind of shuffle there and keep it middle. But again, try not to lean forward too much. Keep the chest, shoulders back, and just more pushing your hips back behind you. Looks good. Everybody have all right. 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 more. Okay, and then I'm going to give you those jumping jacks. All right, let's get butt right up a little bit here with some jumping jacks. I'm busy. What were you getting for dinner, Leslie? Far away or close? Right here.
Okay, awesome.
Yes.
And then you go?
Yeah. Yeah. Right? Good. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then we're going down, you guys. Okay, you can go low plank or you can go high plank. Okay, you're going to go low. You'll do your taps here. If you guys know it, or if you want to stay high, you can do your taps here. And to up the intensity, you could add a jump with both feet out, just like a regular plank jack. So plank, taps, or jacks. And that's the warm up. So we're going to go right back to those squats with the reach. Make sure that your bottom is down while you're here. Give me 10 more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, oh my God. Squat with a reach. What are you doing? You have plans?
No, we have no plans.
Awesome.
That's good.
How about you, girls?
Nope.
Yeah. That's nice. Nice. Right? Yeah, very nice. I have a house myself. That's nice. I have that tomorrow, Thursday. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
You know what?
I know last Thursday after I blew away, I was like, shoot, we should have just gone and had wine.
I know. We both had nothing to do.
I would have done that, yeah. I know, right? Yeah. They're like study outfits, it's fine.
Awesome.
Okay.
Well, good. Nice truck.
Right? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then there we go. Jumping jacks are next. Okay, or you can make a low impact if you need to. My mom's making dinner, so I don't have to worry about it.
She's so nice.
Yeah, she came up here today and we did like a little spinning. Her back is hurting her so bad. She's like, I think I just need to get on the bike and see if I can move a little bit. She did okay? She did okay. It's so bad that she barely, like, every step, she like sneezes and it sends like wiping down her legs, you know? She's going. She's had surgery, but let's get back down, you guys. Next week, she's doing some sort of injection thing where, like, they have to actually put her out.
Oh, yeah.
So hopefully it works. So it's lower back?
I think so, too. So she's got 2 spinal fusions. Like, she's lost there, but, like, it didn't help.
Wow.
But they say once you start that kind of stuff, like, they told her it's just going to be ongoing. Like,
so I don't know. She's going to be cutting hair off of a school here, I have a feeling, pretty soon.
Hey, Lizzie, I'm in.
Yeah. You a honey?
That's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay. Come on, back with you guys. Yeah, come on. You can do this one right here. One more time. Alright, squat with the reach. Squat with the reach.
Yes.
We're doing it.
Oh, you're in the reach.
High reach.
I can see. There's really nowhere to go.
I get you.
Yeah, why don't you put my leg out? And I'm going to put David. I can see where the other
way. Wait, wait.
Yeah.
So you guys, keep it coming.
Eight. Seven. Doing six. Five. Four. I'm going to change my view here.
Three. Two and one, and then the side lunge is right here. I can work right here, but I
can't.
I'm sorry.
No, no. Look at it like a big stretch there.
Really go back.
Borrow in your hips, okay? Borrow in your hips. Ten.
Oh,
nine.
Eight.
Seven,
six,
five, four, right to those jumping jacks. One more time. Quick set. Okay, quick set.
Let's go.
Try to get a little clap at the top, too.
Yeah.
10 seconds. Seven, those quick taps for jacks.
Yeah, exactly.
Come on. You can come in. Five. Four more, three more, two, and then you're playing taps or jacks, okay? Last time.
Nice job, you guys. Okay, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, ready to roll?
Oh, yeah.
I have
things
up. You guys good?
Oh, my gosh, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's what's coming, guys. We're going to start with deadlifts, but we're going to spice it up just a little bit here with a step. So it's just a small little step. So I'm going to start here, kind of a mid stance. I'm just going to do the deadlifts, and then I'm just going to step. See how that just kind of come all the way up. Give yourself just a little bit of a relief at the top. You can go a little bit wider if you feel comfortable taking those feet outside the hips a little bit. You can try that. So I'm using the heaviest weight here to start, okay? Keeping your shoulders, just everything kind of back and down, okay? Step. Make shoulders back. And then eyes just come like about 10 inches in front of your toes when you're in the hinge. It just forces you to fully stand up, okay?
Yeah.
And we're gonna stay right here 15 more seconds. And then I've got a static lunge for you. Step, hinge, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then we're going to go static lunges. We'll do one side at a time. So you're going to use your right arm with your right leg, and you're going to just pop into your lunge position. And then you're just going to go straight down, straight up. So I would say if you need a lighter weight, okay, grab something a little bit lighter. And then just kind of breathe through it, right? Drop that back, be good. Really good. Straight down, straight out. Right, feels kind of good. Just about 12 seconds of that way. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, and then just step in, switch it. Pop that other way to the top of the shoulder, that arm side back there, and then you can either put that other hand on the
head,
and then just deep breaths, right? Just deep breaths there.
Awesome.
Hey, give me 12 more seconds, and then I'm going to give you guys a little modified kind of burpee. 10, 9, 7, 6, 5, one more, you guys, give me one more. So, and then I'll show you here. We're going to do a modified burpee. So you're going to take it, you're going to take your feet down, go out, in, right? Functional movement, and then two kicks at the top, okay? Now, if you wanted to up the intensity, you can kick out with a full burpee, okay? But I kind of like these. Get your heart rate up. Try it out. Being low impact. And if you don't buck one out to the ground, You guys could do a squat with a kick at the top. So the mod would be like squat to kick. Squat to kick. That will get your heart rate up as well.
Yeah.
Try to stay up tall when you go for that kick.
Yeah.
And use your core to pull the legs. Really good. So, and two more. And then one more, and then we'll come back up. Grab our heavier set of weights there. Okay, once you're back to your feet, and we go right back to that side-stepping deadlift. Okay, so just right back to the top. I'm just working with 12s, but I would say anywhere from 10 to 20 pounds is worth on this one. So start here,
good.
And then just step, right?
Yes,
it's
kind of
flat back, like your hinge is up. Okay, you are in power. You can even use like the middle of your mat, yeah, as a guide. Every time you step back in, right to the middle, and step out of your. But keep your shoulders strong, right? Yeah, that's so great because they really work your upper back too. We're controlling those weights. Not letting your shoulders round forward. You're good. Okay, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then we're going to that single press there.
Oh, yeah.
So test it out, right? Make sure you go back. You have that nice angle on that front thigh. And then just press down. How does this feel? Does it just feel okay on that leg? Stretching it out a little bit. Good. And you're going to push it through the group.
Awesome.
Okay, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, pass it off. Okay. So she back, Teresa, again before the she back again before the weekend,
or she went back on Saturday night and then she went back Wednesday. She's driving. They don't have anybody to wash her legs.
Yeah.
Gone.
Yeah.
Because the family's sitting here.
Yeah. 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 Seven. 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, and then your modified burpees, okay? Or like I said, you can add just a squat with a kick if you want to stay off of the ground, okay? Squat to kick. Alright, stretch it out a little bit. As you go down there, stretch the back of the legs. Give it off. 15 more seconds and then we're just going to work through it one more time. 10, 9, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Give me a second to get up to your feet. You guys finish when you're on and then we'll go. One more time. Back to that deadlift. Okay, shoulders, give them a roll there. I had to talk to Sue. Have you guys talked to her?
No.
Now, I'm sure she did
that.
We had a really good yoga turnout.
You had a really good
yoga turnout.
Oh, did you?
Yes.
Yeah.
It was
beautiful.
10 seconds, guys. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, right to your ones. I know I'm pushing you guys. Just keep this pace here. And the way we stay warm, like the cardio is just kind of naturally built into the workout. Straight down, straight out. Okay. On the opposite side, if you will, balance there or on the hip to your works.
Okay.
Yes, okay. Okay, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Awesome. Just think they got like a minute of work, 1 minute of work, and then we'll get some water. This is like part of the game. Come all the way up and then press. All right. That was great. 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay. Yeah, just get right to it.
It doesn't matter a lot.
Well, what are we talking about? I am going to do this today, okay? Yeah, our kids, I think, for sure. Yeah. So we're going to kick those kicks up high, guys. Kick them high. Halfway. There's 15 on you, 15 more. Everybody's fine. What are you guys doing?
10, 9, 7, 5, 4, 3, 2, finish the one you're on, and then get yourself a little drink of water. All right, guys. Water. And then we are going to start with legs, but we're going to shift gears a little bit and go down to the floor. So you're going to start with one of my favorite things, the squat chop. Okay, so don't think kettlebell swing or dumbbell swing. Think more straight arms. Okay. So I'm just going to use maybe one weight, okay? And I'm going to hold it down like this. And I'm just going to chop it, okay? So bottom goes straight down. You don't have to tap it to the ground, but if you can get it down there, great, and then chop it up. Again, it's not a swing. I'm not swinging. I'm actually using my arms and my back to work. I mean, this 12 or 15 is pretty decent. If I was really trying to push, I could go 20, but we're going to go right down into the chest on the mat. So start to go with me, and then I'll tell you what's next here. You're going to do a chest press, okay? We're going to add maybe a little bit of a pulse on it, since we're probably working with a little bit lighter set of weights. So we'll give you guys a bridge with it, too. I'm going to give you a blue bridge. Straight down, straight up, right? And try not to lean forward. Like when I go down, look, my eyes stay up. Just literally sit. So my spine stays neutral. Awesome. 10 more seconds. It should get your heart rate up too a little bit. It's got a little sneaky cardio built into this. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay. And then let me show you here, just so we keep it full body, even on the floor here, we're going to add in the hips. So you're going to pop your hips up, pop your dumbbells up, so you come up into that nice solid glute core there, and then you're going to angle your elbows in just ever so slightly, so not all the way up there, in a little. Okay, you're going to add a little pulse, and then press up. So down, it's almost like you're almost at the bottom twice, so 1, 2, and then close it. And then just put your eyes up. Try to relax through your neck, right? Chin is up. And then focus too on keeping the hips high. Squeeze those pecs at the top, right? Keep them as you come to the top. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then one of my all-time favorites, pullover, which is going to kind of mimic the squat that you just did. So you're going to pull it over and down the leg, straight arms. Okay, so it's kind of mimicking that. Mimicking that chopping, okay? And you don't have to come up all the way, but at least get the shoulders out enough to where you're feeling it in those upper abs. Arms are straight. All the way over to the floor.
So basically, your goal on defense is
and then try to meet the toe. And try to
beat up that guy.
Two weights is too for one weight is not enough. You could always put two lighter ones together, which would be great. And you just got 10 seconds and you're going to come right back up to that squat with that chop. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay.
I actually like that one.
I love a pullover. It's
I do. I
actually like it. It does.
Yeah.
Which is why I don't think I love deadlifts too, because I'm not a super heavy one. But that hinging,
yeah,
feels great. All right, back to the top. So squat with a chop. Decide if it was enough. If you're going to do a different size, like any of it, let me know. Okay. So take your feet about as wide as a yoga mat there. And then just lock those arms. Really strong. Like a chop that goes like a piece of wood, right? So then at the top, you're giving some fun little sweeps. Six, seven, 10, 9, 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. Okay, and then we're going down for a chest press. Add the pulse with it. If you really add those hips for you too. Deep breath, check the hips, if they fall down a little bit, great, bring that back up, and 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, yeah. And then switch to just one weight, okay, turn those legs nice and long. And you're coming up with just a single leg here. As high as you're comfortable getting your shoulders up.
We might have had that
before,
too. See, that's just so
good. Now we're going to watch the run. Long legs.
It's like, okay. It's like, okay.
I don't know. It's like a laugh.
Wow. We probably, we actually, next, we might get no side next week.
We got one more set of this.
People will
be jumping back up to our feet here. 12 seconds.10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. All right. And then come on down. Lay down with me one more time.
Okay.
Right. Set yourself up.
Okay.
On this first side, really think about digging your feet in or digging those heels in and firing up those hamstrings and glutes.
Right,
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ready to pull it over, drop to the line.
Cause she knew.
Yeah.
And she's like, yes. Oh my God. And I'll tell you what, all of 100 members of her would be a Florida guy. So I thought she might say no.
Right.
But she looked around and said,
use your core there, use your core. Okay, 15 seconds.
And you know what? Not everybody does it. You know that. It's on purpose. You've got some trouble.
10. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Nice work, you guys. All right. Come on out. Grab some water. Okay. So we're going to go into... We only got one more circuit with weights, okay? And then we'll do abs, so quads up. So next we're going to do water. We're going to do one at a time because this, with the way the timing is and it's short, we do one side at a time on these exercises. I feel like it just gives you a little bit of a bigger burn. So curtsy lunges this time, and you're going to actually step with it, and you're going to give me an Arnold press. So a single Arnold, so this. And then we're gonna go into bicep curls, and we're gonna do a little combo with some curls. And then we're doing reverse grip bent rows, which really goes nicely with your bicep curls. And then we're gonna do some push-ups, where I'm gonna give you like a mod for the push-ups. So grab a drink, we'll start with maybe, you guys decide, right arm, if you kind of go together, then
the arm that you're holding is the leg that goes back.
Correct.
And then modeling it.
Yep. So if you'll start, I'll show you. You'll have your palm facing the in, basically, here.
Sure.
And then you curtsy back. And then you turn and press the palm away when you're at the top. And again, that arm to the side can help there. Right here. Just take your time, get a focal point because I feel like it does throw you off balance a little bit.
You're good. You're
so good. You might be over. Same arm, the leg goes back. Now you're
ready.
And then you press. Yeah, just a little twist. So just hold it at the chin. Just by holding it at the chin, okay, it's going to work that shoulder.
Yep.
Perfect. Okay. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Oh, my arm, right? 3. 2, yeah. Swing it out.
Woo! Yeah.
Arms are going to be both toasty after this last circuit. Yeah. Turn it back. Come on.
Right.
If you'd like to let that back knee kind of lightly tap the floor, you can. Otherwise, it's almost there. So it's almost down. And then right out. Yep. So all the way through to the glutes there. Ooh, that was long. Do it at the bottom. Okay. Bend it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, now the biceps. And you're going to do a combo. So you're going to start with the weight at the top, and you're going to do single, double. So you're just going to open one, close it, open the other, and then you'll do both. And that's it. So nothing fancy. Okay, you'll do a single, double. So I would say medium-sized weight. Or I always feel like one of my weakest things, my thighs. So if you have to say with all singles too, you could do just all singles. Leave the double out. Right? Control it on the way down. So it goes right to the thigh, right to the shoulder. It's been perfect though. Just take your time. Keep that elbow in right into the rib. Okay. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Oh, this one's going to start to burn a little bit more.
I will.
You are reverse grip throw. So I'm going to try to stay with the same weight. You're going to take the hands down so you've got that flat back, palms face away. And you're just driving those elbows up and back. Or again, right along the side of your body there. Put your weight in your heels though. If you feel any kind of pain in your lower back, it just needs to be lighter. Just feel lighter. I won't keep you here long. Yes. 10, 9, 8, we'll go up and back. 7, 5, 4, 3.
Nice, Becky. All right.
Yep, that's perfect.
One. And done, you guys.
Okay. Now you're going to do a push-up here. And I was going to give you guys a little stretch with it. So you do like that rocking push-up to where you're on your knees. You add the push-up there. And you can push back into your child's pose. So I'll rock forward, push-up, and then kind of let myself sit back onto my knee there. So big child's pose. The knees have to be somewhat not too far apart. I'd say if you want to get them a little, like this distance, maybe. And then stretch back there.
How did things go on Wednesday?
Nice, you guys.
I helped.
Very nice.
You are exactly
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
That's kind of good, right? In the front foot. So front foot, power through the heel. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then you've got your bicep combo there. If you didn't feel like it was challenging, then I would increase the lead. Okay? Start with it up at the chin, kind of right here in front of the shoulder. Okay? Go to the thigh. Single, double. We're going halfway down. That's not it. Right. Awesome. I'll give you a little challenge on our third set, okay? We'll go a bunch of doubles on the end. Try not to put your body too much behind it. Use more of just the arm. Isolate the arms. 12, 11, 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Let's do one more. 3, 2. Double on the end, and then you're going to those reverse rows. So I just think to myself, okay, lower into like where you would go, like just on your deadlift, right? I'm just going to hinge right there. Palms out, and then go up and back with my elbows. Think longer than that. Right, your chin is up. Your hammies are probably feeling it too, right? Back to the legs. Nice work. 12, 11. Get ready to go right down to those push-ups. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, and this will feel good, you guys. Come on down. Keep your arms kind of close to your body. We didn't really do any triceps tonight, so this will help kind of hit those tries. So you go down, right? Push out, and then go ahead and hinge all the way up, and up there. Push yourself into that challenge pose, and really take the stretch there through the sides of your back there. That should feel great after those rollovers we did. I guess the more challenging piece could be to do it on your feet. You want to do it up on your toes. Okay, now let's do it up. Okay, grab 10, 9, 8, 7,
go one more time. Back to your curtsy with your single press. Okay. We're ready. 3, 2, 1, let's go. What are you doing? What are you making? What are you making?
I'm not making anything. I'm going to go home and I'm going to fix myself something healthy, some veggies.
It's like your husband. He seems to be much
glad
better.
Back to work out.
Yeah. You did great. You said you got a little tired.
Yeah.
Okay, 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, other side. We're going,
pork chops and pierogies is what we're having.
Oh, okay.
Sure.
My mom was like, do you want me to dinner? And I was like, sure, that'd be great. And applesauce, that's what she
yeah.
did.
Yeah,
that's
a traditional.
Okay.
Good.
Okay. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, yeah. Oh, goodness. All right. Woo. Bicep, you guys. Once you got your weight, okay, come on up. Give yourself that shoulder hole. And for everything, back and down. Start at the top here. We'll keep it close, but just think, in about 2 minutes, we're going to go right to those abs. You're almost done with these weights. Super good. We're going to start with a little bird dog, though, so when we come down to the abs, we're going to stay kind of facing, like, our, we'll turn over after we do the bird dog.
There you go.
I promised you guys some doubles on the end here. You ready for it? Okay, let's go. All doubles, if you want them, if you want them. You've got 15 seconds. Just think, burn these out. 10, 9, 8, keep your back strong. 7, 6, 5, awesome. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh.
Woo! All right, and then
yeah.
Change it if you need to.
Yes.
Grab what you got for your throws there.
Guys,
so isn't that a good little super set though, you guys?
It is.
How to do reverse throws and push-ups. Right? You get a big turn in a little bit of time. 10, 9, 8, 7. Come on, really squeeze that upper back. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Let's do it. Done with your weights, guys. Done with your weights. Do our little rocker push-ups here. Okay, remember, elbows kind of going along your ribs there. And you push back. Breathe through it. Take a deep breath as you go for that push-up. In through the nose. And then exhale through the mouth. We're going to do 15. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then we're set up right to go to a little bird dog here. So just come into like a little tabletop position. Maybe we do our left arm and our right leg here. So you're going to come in and then press out right there. Try to keep your core real tight. Balance, right? Balance. Reach all the way out and then take that leg. Go out with your heel and then kind of raise up at the very end there of the move. Only do this one time. Okay, I'm going to have you do a little hold here. 10 seconds and we'll hold it out. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, now just come out and hold it right here. Really big stretch out. Okay? Four tight. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6,
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Jenny, was that all right? Was your wrist feeling okay on that? Try not to restrict your breathing while you're doing this. Just like you did that on those bird dogs. Reach all the way out for that heel out, like you're going to push it through the wall across the room. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then we're going to do our little cocoons here. We're going to come up and kind of grab your knees. Double up the knees now. And if you want to, you can kind of scoop the arms out and then scoop the arms in. You can bring the knees in towards your chest and really try to keep your shoulders up and off the floor there. With that lower back that you kind of round the body. Feels really good there. Stretches it out. Anytime you feel like you needed relief or you feel like your lower back needs a break, single side, okay? You can always do one at a time. One scoop in. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 1. Heel taps. 3, 2, okay, guys, now the heel taps are right here. Keep moving right along. Back to like that head rest. You're going to do those single leg drops right here. So put your leg back up in that tabletop position. We'll do a couple of these. We'll do some crunches. We'll do some leg lifts. And then I think just a couple of Russian twists and we'll finish with our plank. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three,
two. Now you got the leg lifts. Okay. And if you need to modify them, you can modify with single legs, one at a time. Give you a nice big set of these. Deep breaths, 20 seconds. Fifteen, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now before we flip over, or before we sit up actually, let's put our feet together and we're just going to circle to the right. Okay, couple little circles to the right. Just a few right here. 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Let it rest for a second there. One more. 3, 2, up and to the left. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, sit up, give me your twist real quick. Right here, side to side, and then when you are done, guys, okay, holy.
So that's for my makeup.
You made it.
I'm sorry. Everything.
Okay. Yeah. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Oh, okay. All right, girlies. Back to our plank. Lock in. Okay. Once you're here, if you want to, just draw forward and back a couple times. This should feel kind of good. Draw into your heels, then shift into your toes just a couple times. You'll feel it through your shoulders and your back as well. And then we'll flat, and then push back in our heels and hold it. 10 seconds, we'll hold. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Let's go back to the heels and hold. Lock in. 15 seconds. So we did it. Chest, shoulders, back, biceps, a little bit of triceps, not a ton. Shoulder cardio for 4. Obviously for the legs. You got 8 seconds and you're done. Crunch. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and there it is. Whew. We did it. It did take about 50 minutes. So great job, you guys. Thank you so much. Awesome job. Make sure you stretch, grab some water too on your way out. Okay.